Hey guys, in this new video, we're going to take a look at the calculations behind Gibbs free energy. So if we take a look at example one, it says, the reduction of iron 3 oxide with hydrogen produces iron metal and can be written as follows. So we have 1 mole of iron 3 oxide solid reacting with 3 moles of hydrogen gas to give us 2 moles of iron solid plus 3 moles of water vapor. I give you the delta H or enthalpy value and the delta S entropy value. The question says, is this reaction spontaneous under standard state conditions at 25 degrees Celsius? If not, at what temperature will it become spontaneous? So this is a two-part question. So they're asking us if it's spontaneous or not. Remember, the best variable to calculate spontaneity is delta G. So I gave you delta H, I gave you delta S, and we have temperature. So we can use delta G zero equals delta H zero minus T delta S zero. And we know we should use this version because I'm saying standard state conditions. So we're supposed to use delta G with a zero. So what we need to do next is we have to make sure that our delta H and our delta S values agree in units. Here, delta H uses kilojoules, but delta S uses joules. Now, kilojoules are the default type of units for these types of questions. So let's just convert the delta S to kilojoules as well. So remember, we're gonna say for every 1,000 joules, there is 1 kilojoule. So this is equivalent to 0.1415 kilojoules over K. So we're gonna plug in the 98.8 kilojoules minus, temperature has to be in Kelvin as well. So add 273.15 to the 25. That gives us 298.15 Kelvin times the delta S value we just calculated. So the Kelvins will cancel out. So it'll be kilojoules minus kilojoules. When we do that, we get an answer of 56.633 kilojoules. Now remember, if delta G is negative, then it's going to be spontaneous. The fact that we got a positive answer means that this reaction is not spontaneous. So now it's up to us to figure out what temperature will it become spontaneous. Now, anytime they ask you at what temperature does it become spontaneous, that means you assume that delta G zero is equal to zero. Okay, so we're gonna use this same exact equation here, except now delta G is zero. And that still equals the same value for delta H, the same value for delta S. Here, we're not gonna know what temperature is. That's what we're trying to solve. So zero equals 98.8 kilojoules minus T times 0.1415 kilojoules over K. What we're gonna do first, we're gonna subtract out the 98.8 kilojoules. And that equals negative T times 0.1415 kilojoules over K. We need to isolate temperature by itself, so we're gonna divide out negative 0.1415 kilojoules over K on both sides. So this cancels out with this, and the negative sign also cancels out. So we have a negative getting divided by another negative. Kilojoules cancel out. Our answer will be in Kelvin. So temperature here equals 698.233 temperature. Now, technically, if we take that number and plug it back in, then delta G will equal zero. Remember, when delta G equals zero, we're at equilibrium. We're technically still not spontaneous. So what you would say is temperatures above this answer would give you a spontaneous reaction. So we're gonna say temperatures above this answer would be spontaneous. Temperatures below it would be non-spontaneous. So make careful sure, like when you're looking at your exam, what exactly are they asking you in terms of temperature? Are they looking for an exact answer, or are they asking at what temperature will it be spontaneous? Just remember, when you work it out, the temperature you get, that's technically the temperature at equilibrium. So all you have to say is any temperature above that, whether it be like 0.00001 degrees higher, it's still going to be spontaneous. It'll just be a little bit spontaneous. Okay, so remember, the answer you get, temperatures above that answer will make your reaction spontaneous. Now that we've done example one together, I want you guys to attempt to do practice one. Here we're saying if delta G is small and positive, which of the following statements is true? And I'll give you guys a huge hint. Remember, we have to think of delta G in three situations: when it's less than zero, equal to zero, or greater than zero. What do each of those mean? What do I mean by the word small? Also, remember, if you're spontaneous one way, then you'll be non-spontaneous the other way. Just because delta G is positive doesn't mean it can't be spontaneous, period. It would be non-spontaneous in the forward. But what about the reverse? Ask yourself these questions and you'll be able to answer this question really quickly. Good luck, guys.